Hello, future engineers. Welcome to my YouTube channel. If you're still new to my channel and you like what I'm doing, please don't forget to share my videos to your friends and to your friends' friends. That's one way you can keep me going, inspired and refreshed. Now, if you find my videos interesting and important to your studies, also please don't forget to subscribe. So here is the problem. Draw qualitative influence lines for the vertical reactions at supports A and B, the bending moment at point B, and the shear and bending moment at point C of the beam shown below. Also show the arrangements of a uniformly distributed downward live load WL to cause the maximum upward reactions at supports A and B, the maximum negative bending moment at B, the maximum negative shear at C, and the maximum positive bending moment at C. So here is the given beam. So first, for the positive vertical reactions at A, by principle, we replace this section IA by a mechanism such that it cannot resist upward movement. But there is still resistance to moment as shown. So by pushing this up, the corresponding deflected shape would look like this. And that would be the qualitative influence line for the vertical reaction at A. So therefore, to maximize the positive vertical reaction at A, the load portion of the qualitative influence line where it is above the horizontal line or where it is positive as shown in the figure. So we load portion AB with live load. Then next is DE. Then that would be the position or load arrangements of the live load to cause maximum positive reaction at A. Next, for B. So for B, we have to push B upward, and this will be the expected deflected shape. And therefore, to maximize the positive upward reaction at B, we load portion ABCD with uniform live load as well as EF as shown in the figure. So that's the arrangement of live load for maximum positive BY. Then for bending moment at B, so remember B will only rotate. We replace this by an interior hinge as shown, then apply positive moments. So it will cause to bend this way. And therefore, that's the influence line for qualitative influence line for moment at B. And to arrange the live load to cause maximum negative bending moment at B, then we have to load this portion ABCD because it is negative as well as EF as shown in the figure. So that's the arrangement of live load for maximum negative MB. Then finally, then for shear, next, for negative shear, so we replace C by section C by a mechanism such that it cannot resist shear, then apply positive shear forces as shown, and this will be the expected deflected shape. So that's the qualitative influence line for shear at sea. Then to maximize the negative shear at sea, we arrange the live load on portion BC and DE for negative shear at sea, as shown in the figure. So that's the arrangement of live load for maximum negative shear at sea. And finally, for maximum moment at sea, so the qualitative influence line would look like this, as shown. And therefore, to maximize the positive moment at sea, we arrange the live load in such a way that it is over BCD and over EF, as shown in the figure. So that's it. And based on this idea, I hope that you were able to follow the explanation and solutions. And when you are confronted with problems on maximizing this specific certain specific response function or specific response function, then you should be able to arrange the live load that will cause maximum influence or effect to that required function by the method of analyzing continuous beams, either three moment equations or slope deflection equations. Then from there, answer the possible questions. So that's it for this problem.